Welcome to Merkin Hall at Kaufman Music Center. Before we begin, please take a moment to silence your mobile devices. Thank you, and enjoy the show.
Welcome, I'm Daniel Kellogg, president of Young Concert Artists, and I'm so delighted that you're all here for this concert this evening. Tonight's concert is the Michaels Award concert. The Michaels, a family from Chicago, began supporting a YSA artist debut back in 1970 and have been supporting it ever since. So I'd like to recognize and thank the Michaels family. I'd also love to take a moment to recognize YCA founder Susan Wadsworth. Hello, Susan. Before I introduce tonight's artist, there are two concerts coming up that we'd love for you to know about. Next week, April 24th on Wednesday at noon, violinist Luen Lee will perform an unaccompanied violin recital at the Morgan Library and Museum. Then on May 20th at Carnegie Zenkel Hall, 14 YCA artists, both current and alums, will perform a wonderful season finale concert. We hope you'll join us for one or both of these concerts. You can find details on our website. Our work at Young Concert Artists is to discover really extraordinary young musicians filled with tremendous potential to have major concert careers. We then give them debut concerts here in New York and in Washington, give them guidance and nurturing, and help them begin what become wonderfully fulfilling careers that span decades. Chaeyoung Park joined our roster in November of 2022, and I remember at the auditions, she had this beautiful concentration and focus. She was playing an adagio that took our breath away. She is a serious and thoughtful artist, and this is a really special and robust program. She's chosen three pieces, three composers that she loves, and we're delighted that you're here to hear her play. Immediately following the concert, there will be a wine reception upstairs. If you take the stairs in the lobby right upstairs, we'd love to offer you a complimentary glass of wine, and we hope you'll spend time congratulating Chaeyoung and visiting with her. So thank you again for being here, and please enjoy.
Thank you. Thank you, everyone, so much for being here today. I'm really excited to share this program with you, which is centered around Beethoven's Hammerklavier Sonata, which I will talk more about in the second half when the time comes. But I wanted to create a program that also, like the Beethoven Sonata, similarly pushed boundaries in all aspects. So you heard the first book of Debussy Etudes, which, as much as it is a technical exercise for the pianist, it was actually a compositional exercise for him as well. So by limiting himself to certain intervals, he is exploring what kind of sound and emotional landscape he can create within those limitations. And I think Debussy is one of the most important classical music composers by reinventing our understanding of harmonies. And I think these collection of etudes are some of the most colorful pieces in the piano literature. So I'm really happy to share that with you today. The next piece on the program is George Crumb's Little Suite for Christmas. I must first apologize that I'm playing such a winter piece and on a sunny spring day, but I really wanted to include this because George Crumb was a pioneer in something called the extended piano technique. And extended piano technique literally is extending our understanding of what piano is as an instrument. So obviously I play most of the time here, but Crumb thought, you know, piano is a big instrument. Why not take advantage of the fact that we have all this real estate available here? So in this piece, you will see me reach inside the piano and pluck some strings, strum some things, and make sounds that you probably never have heard come out of the instrument. And Crumb, even though it is an unfamiliar sound, it is actually a beautiful, beautiful atmosphere that he is able to create with these new sound worlds. So I wanted to include and introduce Crumb, who I also think is one of the most important composers in classical music and specifically in the piano literature. So yes, without further ado, here is Crumb, and thank you again for coming.
Thank you. vezzoso porse il pomo alla più bella mia diletta villanella io ti morgo questi fiore ma di lui più glorioso più di lui felice io sono poiché in premio del mio dono poiché in premio del mio dono ne riporto il tuo bel cuore Veggo chiaro in quel visino ch'io fo breggia nel tuo petto. Non è cosa sorprendente, son galante e son sergente. Va bella che resista alla vista d'un cimiero, cede a Marte Dio guerriero, in la madre dell'amor, cede a Marte Dio guerriero. La madre dell'amor cede a Marte Dio guerriero la madre cede a Marte Dio guerriero
Artists today are more than simply gifted, highly trained musicians. They are storytellers, entrepreneurs, innovators, business people, and artist citizens empowered to boldly communicate the power of music. YCA Career Catalyst is an online resource offering specialized courses and weekly vlogs and blogs with guidance and insight from industry experts on marketing, finance, mental health, and other skills needed for young musicians to realize their goals for a self-empowered and self-directed career in music. The world is a better place when creative artists thrive. Visit ycacareercatalyst.org.
Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you for staying for the second half. Now for the next piece and the final piece on the program is Beethoven's Hammerklavier Sonata. Usually when I tell people that I'm playing this piece to other musicians and fellow pianists, I get a wide variety of responses, ranging anywhere from, why would you do that to yourself? That's a little Beethoven sonata you're playing right there. And the Hammerklavier holds a special place in the piano repertoire because it is considered one of the most challenging pieces and also one of the most, one of the lengthiest pieces that are written for solo piano. And it has such a range from a symphonic first movement, a scherzo, like 2 minute short second movement, the longest and the most heartfelt slow movement, and a iconic and crazy finale, which is a crazy fugue. And this piece, he actually didn't really even write it for his fellow pianists of his time. There's a famous letter which mentions this piece, and he writes, "Now, I'm writing a sonata that pianists will only be able to play in 50 years. And now it's 200 years later, and we are still struggling with this piece. But I think this piece is akin to reading a great novel, perhaps a lengthy one, but a great one, in that perhaps it requires some patience and some trust and some work from the reader or the listener. But when you get to the last paragraph and you finish and you close the book cover, you feel full at heart and you feel like a different person. And that's how I feel every time I listen or play this piece, that it changes me a little bit as a person. So I hope you will let Beethoven change you today, slightly. And thank you again so much for being here, and enjoy Hammerklavier.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.